On the 20th of July, 1944, a young Nazi officer held the fate of the German nation in his hands. In his briefcase was a bomb. His target was Adolf Hitler. His plan to kill the German dictator, seize power, and save his country from total destruction. This is the story of Operation Valkyrie, the plot to kill Hitler. By 1944, the tide of the Second World War had turned against Germany. Crushing defeats in Russia and a successful invasion of Europe by the Allies had forced the German army into retreat on all fronts. Hitler's opponents, many from within his own army, believed that the time was right to assassinate the Nazi leader and seize power. On July the 14th, 1944, Hitler flew to the Wolf's Lair, his East Prussian headquarters at Rastenburg. For the conspirators, it was the moment they'd been waiting for. The plan was to detonate a bomb during one of Hitler's daily war conferences. With the Führer dead, they would stage a coup in Berlin by mobilizing the reserve army. The reserve army had been given an emergency plan called Operation Valkyrie, which was to be used in the event of a breakdown in law and order. The conspirators planned to hijack Operation Valkyrie. The men of the reserve army would take control, disarm the SS, and arrest the Nazi leadership, while all the time thinking they were being loyal to the Führer. On the 20th of July, Hitler rose early. Among those due to attend the conference was Claus von Stauffenberg, the reserve army's chief of staff. Stauffenberg was a disillusioned, aristocratic officer who had fought bravely in Poland, France, and North Africa. He had lost an eye, his right hand, and part of his left in North Africa, and during his recovery, Stauffenberg had turned against the Nazi leader. He met with a group of conspirators and put himself forward as the man to finally kill Adolf Hitler. On his way to the daily conference, Stauffenberg stopped to arm the devices concealed in his briefcase. Surprised by a passerby, he only armed one of the two bombs. Stauffenberg entered the meeting room and stood two places to Hitler's right. At about 12:40, he announced that he had to make a call to Berlin. Hiding his briefcase under the table, he left the room. Moments later, a fellow officer moved the briefcase out of his way behind one of the heavy oak legs of the table. As Stauffenberg walked to his car, the bomb exploded, destroying the conference room. Thinking that Hitler was dead, Stauffenberg raced to Berlin. In the German capital, General Friedrich Olbricht, Stauffenberg's co-conspirator, had declared a state of emergency and seized key strategic points across the city. However, it soon became clear that all was not going according to plan. While Stauffenberg and many of his conspirators believed Hitler to be dead, others had heard that he was still alive and hesitated to carry out their part of the plan. While the conspirators argued about what to do next, Adolf Hitler was dusting himself down and surveying the damage. While four of his officers had died, Hitler had only sustained minor injuries. Hitler called Berlin, instructing his loyal officers to restore order, and went off to meet Benito Mussolini, the Italian fascist dictator. Propaganda minister Joseph Goebbels went on the radio to announce the failed plot to kill Hitler. Shortly afterwards, Stauffenberg and several of his co-conspirators were arrested, tried, and immediately shot. At 10 p.m. that evening, Hitler triumphantly broadcast to the nation, boasting of his survival. The Führer's revenge was absolute. Over 7,000 people were rounded up, among them senior members of the intelligence service and the army. Those who survived interrogation were subjected to show trials before a people's court. Hitler ordered that the guilty be hung like cattle, and the conspirators were strung by their necks with wire and suspended from meat hooks. Their slow and painful deaths were filmed and later shown to Hitler. The failure of Operation Valkyrie encouraged Hitler's delusional belief that he was protected by fate and could never fail. The events of the next few months were to prove him wrong, and by the spring of 1945, Germany was on her knees. He had survived nearly 6 years of war and countless attempts on his life, but on the 30th of April 1945, under the ruins of his once great capital, Adolf Hitler took his own life. 1 week later, the war in Europe was over.